right, it's a great pleasure to chair this next part of the session this morning. We have a selection of six short talks selected from the abstracts. And our first speaker in this part of the session is Mark Müller-Lino from the Forschungszentrum in Jülich, and he will present 3D imaging approaches in quantitative plant phenotyping, application scenarios in the lab and in the field.
So thank you very much for the introduction and to the organizers for the invitation to this nice conference. I'm working in the group of Fabio Fiorani at the It's not on? Can you hear me? Okay, that will be a tough task now. I'm working in the group of Fabio Fiorani at the Forschungszentrum Jülich in the Institute of Plant Sciences. And I would like to introduce you to some of our 3D imaging matches methods that we are applying in our institute. Just a brief look on our institute and the Forschungszentrum. So we are rightly located there where this red circle is. The institute, the Forschungszentrum itself has up to, I think, 6,000 employees. We have 130 approximately, divided up in five research areas, and 3D imaging plays a role in three of them: enabling technologies and shoot function, novel traits, and in the Jülich Plant Phenotyping Center where I'm located. I would like to give you a very brief overview on some of our activities across the institute, and start with 3D seeds. So what you see here is a 3D reconstruction of single seeds that is implemented in a processing pipeline using a robotic system where different measurements are performed on single seeds, and one of them uses the space carving approach, so a system where a camera images the seed from different position and finally reconstructs a 3D volume. And the trait which we quantify by this approach is basically the seed volume with a very, very high precision. 3D roots, I think that will also be explained by Michelle Watt later in or tomorrow in her talk. What you see here is a 3D reconstruction that comes from an MMR or MRI facility. So we have soil grown roots in small tubes which are imaged in this 4.7 Tesla magnet facility, and with some software that was developed by the authors on the bottom, we are able to track roots through their data that comes from these measurements, and estimate different traits like root length, width, but also growth rates. The 3D shoot part includes several different approaches, but here only depicted two, reaching from very small plants and like Arabidopsis plants up to the plot scale, but I will go to that in more detail in the next examples. And finally, we are also reaching the large scale, the field scale. Here we use UAV imagery in order to estimate the height profiles. Here in this example, in the common experiment of the germ plant phenotyping network, what you see in this section is the height profile of this RGB image on the top. Very interestingly, for instance, are the red squares, and some of them are really destroyed, so that you only see the red border in them, resulting from lodging effects. So I would like now to come to an approach which uses structured light or coded light. This is one of our most precise an approach with a very high resolution and depth resolution. This approach projects a light pattern on leaves or different life patterns and encodes the leaf surface, and by that it is imaged with a camera, and then from these image sequences the 3D surface is estimated. Or you see here an example of a tomato where we use different views on this tomato in order to reconstruct the whole tomato, but this is very applicable for instance for plants like Arabidopsis, which are somehow a little bit 2D, so you need only a few images from or scans from the top and get very, very good results. We then developed an image processing pipeline in order to get more traits out of these data. The first step is, of course, to identify single leaves in order to make also trait estimations on the single leaf level. But to start with that one here is on the plant level. So we could, for instance, analyze leaf area, of course, counting leaves, convex hull, so the typical estimations that you all know, leaf angle distribution as well. And on the single leaf level, we could also go for the single leaf area, of course, and leaf angle, but also for leaf length or other shape parameters with leaf curvature and so on. An approach which was a collaboration with Francisco Pinto, who is now working here at CIMIT, is depicted in the image A. So here you see a stereo camera setup together with a hyperspectral imaging device. We try to co-register our data, but I won't go into detail here. What we did regarding 3D imaging, we tried to estimate the leaf angle distribution within these canopies, which is very important if you make, for instance, light interception modeling or photosynthesis modeling. You need to know orientation, inclination of your leaf in the canopy. And we started with some depth maps, which we computed from the stereo images, and applied or developed the image processing pipeline, which includes these depth maps or 3D representations of the canopy together with some segmented results for single leaves, and together that was then smoothed or fitted with some 2D surface models in order to derive finally the leaf angle distributions of these canopies, like the one which is here depicted for the leaf inclination, but also on a higher level for the leaf inclination and the orientation, which is somehow related to cardinal points, for instance. So what you see down here is a 2D histogram, which combines both distributions. And on the base of that, we performed analysis on different sugar beet cultivars at different time points, and applied analysis like principal component analysis in order to see if the data clusters, and it clusters very well regarding the different developmental states which we had in our study, which is not surprising. But we could also cluster the single cultivars very nicely here. In a recent approach, which was a collaboration with an industrial partner, we developed a mobile, very flexible imaging device, which includes a stereo camera again and also a hyperspectral sensor. That was more from a breeder's perspective, so they gave us a list of traits which was interesting to them, and we then decided which trait we could address with our approach, and some of them are listed here on the bottom. This approach was applied in the field as well as in the greenhouse, and most of the traits we could address here are also very important for the breeder, like the stem diameter at particular positions, which is related to Wico, for instance, or also fruit traits like fruit volume, size, and so on. For that, we developed a semi-automated user interface, so that the user needs to click a few things, like click on the tomato, or click on the leaf, or click on the stem, but all the rest of the analysis was then done automatically. And what you see in this 3D model here on the left, tomatoes were detected automatically regarding size and volume, and also their position within the cluster, and also color was analyzed in the tomatoes and in the leaves, as well as leaf angles and so on. By this, we could very nicely distinguish between different cultivars which were in this case study, and the aim was to see if our approach gives similar results to this manual scorings which the breeders do. Here we are not as far that I can present any results. That is still in progress, but we hope that that is working well. In the last slide or a topic I want to address: video grammetry. Here we applied the stereo camera setup again on this field bike, so a hand-driven mobile platform. Took video sequences with two cameras, automatically identified the ears of using markers, and then computed trajectories of each single ear. This was a very relevant a study regarding, for instance, lodging, because the dynamic parameters of the stem are somehow related to lodging effects, and we wanted to find out if we can see any systematics there. So what we then did is to analyze, for instance, the natural frequency within each individual ear, and also other parameters like amplitude-related parameters or the inclination of the ear pendular plane, and so on. What is depicted here in this analysis is only the natural frequency. This is a nice parameter because it's wind independent, or more or less wind independent if compared to the others, and we could distinguish for instance between short plants and tall plants, but also see clear difference between plants which are more sensitive to lodging than others. With that one, I want to conclude, and you see all the people which are involved here, and want to thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, and thank you for staying in time. We've got time for questions. All right, I'll start with one. So the structured light, any chance that some of the gaming devices like a Kinect will ever be good enough for plants?
I think it depends on what you want to see or estimate. Maybe it will never be as precise as a structured light scanner. So if you want to see, for instance, there are small leaves inside in the center of an Arabidopsis rosette, that will be quite difficult using Kinect or more rough approaches, let's say. But for other traits, it might be good enough, that's clear.
I had a question about the structured light as well. With the Arabidopsis picture, you showed, like in the image of the outline of the leaves, there was like an overlap between individual leaves. Are you estimating overlap between leaves?
You mean the?
As in the second image.
You mean this one?
Yes. Yes.
Comes directly from the scan. So in this case, the plant was not scanned from nadir position, but from different angular positions, let's say, about 8 positions, as far as I remember. And then you can also see under a leaf, and there we could also have some effects like that.
Nice.
Thank you very much.